post jocundam juventutem, post molestam senectutem, nos habebitumus, nos habebitumus. Vivat academia, vivat professores, vivat academia, vivat professores, vivat membrum quod libet, vivat membra quod libet, semper sit in flores, semper sit in flores.
Enga manuhi tu arangi e, nau mai ra, piki mai ra, kia koutou ngā whānau kua eke mai nei, ki te tautoko I te kaupapa nei e, hara mai ra, nau mai ra, kia koutou ngā tauira, kua eke ki te rā taumata, tā koutou pōtaitanga, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou.
Please be seated.
Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoe fa. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of council members and staff of the university. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland at which the Vice-Chancellor and I will award diplomas and confer degrees in the Faculty of Business and Economics. Graduation is a time for celebrating success. Today, you will experience the pomp and tradition of this ancient ceremony and the recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Like your family and friends gathered here, we are very proud of all your achievements and look forward to your lifelong involvement as members of the University of Auckland family. Of course, graduation represents more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, on your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Universities New Zealand has estimated that the lifetime benefits of earning a degree are valued at between $1 million and $4 million. Your university experience and the qualifications gained at university will thus add real value to your lives and to the lives of those around you. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In the Faculty of Business and Economics, we have seen several notable achievements in the last year. Mr. Jeff Witcher was named one of only 18 recipients globally of the inaugural 2016 Rhodes Trust Inspirational Educator Award. Professor Prasanna Guy was awarded a member of the Advisory Scientific Committee of the Systemic Risk Board of the European Community. The board itself comprises the central bank governors of Europe and the UK. Professor Kevin Lowe was awarded the Decade Award by the Journal of International Business for the most influential research article published by the journal in the previous 10 years. He was also named a Fellow of the Southern Management Association of the United States of America. And accounting and finance, information systems and operations management, economics, commercial law, and management and international business were the highest ranked subjects in their respective fields in New Zealand in the 2016 QS subject rankings. We can rightfully be proud of these achievements. In my view, to ensure that we can continue to achieve successes like these and to enhance our contribution to future generations of graduates and to our nation, the university must do three things. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, I believe we're doing very well. The proportion of students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year, and we produce outstanding graduates just like you. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing, as illustrated by the achievements I've just read to you. Many of our staff are world leaders in their fields, and you will have been privileged to learn from and work with them. So it's no coincidence that in the QS World Ranking of University Subjects, the University of Auckland came top in 35 of the 40 ranked subjects, and we don't even teach two of them. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. To this end, the university has been investing heavily in its campus renewal program so as to ensure that we do provide facilities of genuine international quality. Many of you will graduate today with the first qualification, and you will be rightly proud of this achievement. However, I also want you to reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You see, you must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world, but rather be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Although it may seem a daunting prospect right now, further study and learning is inevitable for us all as the world changes around us at an ever-accelerating pace. Whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. But today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you, and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. It's my privilege to introduce our opening speaker, Peter Cullinane, the founder and chief executive of Lewis Road Creamery, one of the fastest growing food businesses in New Zealand. An alumnus of our business school, Peter has combined his business acumen with his strong desire to eat top quality New Zealand made butter and dairy products and has come up with a winning formula. Lewis Road Creamery silver foil wrapped butter and flavoured milk is now a feature in many supermarkets and food speciality stores. And there's no stopping the very successful company which Peter started making butter at his kitchen bench. Peter holds master's degrees in business administration and management and is a member of both the New Zealand Advertising and Marketing Halls of Fame. His previous business experience includes his role as Saatchi & Saatchi's worldwide chief operating officer. And upon his return to New Zealand, he founded the Assignment Group, which has developed some of the country's most iconic brands. Among his many activities, Peter's the director of the Marketing Communications Services Group, WPP AU NZ Limited, and the media companies APN News and Media Limited and NZME Limited. He's also a trustee for the charity Kiwis for Kiwi. It's my pleasure, Peter, to welcome you here today to address us.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of the Council, members of the University, families and friends of the graduates, and most especially, you, the graduates. I know that this is a moment you've been waiting for, not actually this moment, but the moment after this moment. I was asked to provide some brief words of wisdom to you today. That necessarily means that the speech will be pretty short. Today is a momentous day. Your degree is solid proof of your intelligence and some indicator, at least, of your diligence. It confers a well-deserved status because you've earned it from one of the great universities. It's a wonderful and valuable start to your working life. But don't take that as meaning that you have to throw away the lessons of youth. Quite the opposite. You should treasure them. Today hasn't made you suddenly older or more responsible. You've got all the time in the world for that. Protect your youthful enthusiasm, your optimism, and your inquiring mind. Stay youthful in mind and body until you begin to slow down, maybe in your 80s. You know, from here on in, it's your diligence and persistence that will set you apart. Allow me to quote US President Calvin Coolidge on the subject. It's a great quote, I think. Nothing in the world can take the place of persistence. Talent will not. Nothing is more common than unsuccessful men with talent. Genius will not. Unrewarded genius is almost a proverb. Education will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Persistence and determination alone are omnipotent. The slogan, press on, has solved and always will solve the problems of the human race. And perhaps I might quote my rather simpler motto, which is this: where there's a will, there's a way. It's how I judge my actions and my excuses, and it's how I judge others. Put it another way, there's nothing stopping you, because truly, if you can imagine it, you can do it. It's just a matter of how much you want it. So get ready to work hard and to work smart. You have to believe in yourself, not in a sort of a vain way, but with an inner strength of belief and a depth of purpose. Remain a realistic optimist. In all my years, I've never met a successful cynic, so I suggest you avoid them. Surround yourself instead with people who will help lift your head up and look to the future. And yes, you'll occasionally stumble, make a mistake that seems insurmountable, unforgivable, career-ending at the time. Winston Churchill, to my mind perhaps the most fascinating human being ever to walk the halls of power, said, "When you're going through hell, keep going." Frankly, if you're not making mistakes, you're just not trying hard enough. I really do believe that judgment is critical, knowing what is right and what is wrong, what can be fixed and what is best left alone. And judgment can be learnt. Make sure you do learn it. Your future career path will be like never before. My father left straight from the farm here and flew Lancaster bomber aircraft in World War II across the skies of Germany. He came back and flew for Air New Zealand for the rest of his career. So one job, one company. Thankfully, he loved his work. A generation later, I spent almost the entirety of my career in advertising and made a huge switch to starting a branded goods company just 4 years ago. For you, however, it's going to be an entirely different story. It's estimated that today's graduates are likely to have 25 jobs in 5 different industries. So learn to embrace change. Welcome it. Never let yourself get stuck in a rut. There's no excuse. Each to their own, I suppose, but be careful not to trade off the excitement of challenge for the dullness of security. And it's so important that you do what's right for you. Like most of us, you probably grew up wanting to please others. You might even have done a degree that was expected of you rather than one that you might have chosen for yourself. See your graduation, I think, as a beginning, not an end. Now it's your time. Choose to work at things that really excite you. As I read recently, think about your work as not things you've got to do, but things you get to do. The future is so exciting if you have a mix of brains, imagination, and diligence. The old rule books no longer apply, and the new ones are out of date before they're written. Business is no longer built on bricks and mortar or stainless steel. We've got enough of that already, I think. The opportunity is to build and be part of imaginative processes that are created from scratch in a digital world. Here, the barriers to entry are low, not just for tech firms, for any new business, be it clothing, food, medicine, anything, because they can be established in the blink of an eye and with a handful of dollars. And because it is a digital world, you as digital natives have a head start. You know how to operate in this world. And what will make it work is hard work. Because while it's easy for you to create something new, it's just as easy for the person standing to the left and the right of you. So hard work is the thing that will separate you. What does success look like? Well, I guess to many of you, given your degrees, money can be assumed to be a major yardstick of your success, both how you judge yourself and others judge you. But comparison is the thief of joy. There will always be people both more and less successful than you when judged on material possessions. I really believe that you should run your own race, and I suggest that the best definition of success is a life led to the full, a life in which you've made the most of the opportunities and talents in front of you. Financial, perhaps, but also friends, family, sports interests, and generosity of spirit. And call me old-fashioned, conducted with good manners, the oil that keeps the social machine lubricated. Keep your life multidimensional. Be able to look at yourself in the mirror and think, I've made the most of what I've got. Now, I warned that this speech will be short on my accumulated wisdom, but let me finish with this. Today, of all days, is a hugely well-earned recognition of what you've done and what those around you, your family, friends, and your educators have helped you achieve. Celebrate to the max. Be thankful for and acknowledge the help and support you've received. Be joyous and confident as you leave here today, knowing that there's a wonderful future out there waiting for you. Just grab it in both arms and make the most of it. To finish with Sir Winston Churchill again, live dangerously, take things as they come, dread naught, all will be well. So, all the very best to you. We're really proud of you. Begin as you mean to continue and go out and make great things happen. But right now, celebrate. So again, congratulations and all the very best.
Thank you, Peter, for a most insightful and challenging speech. Would you please join with me in thanking Peter once again? This is a meeting of Council in Convocation of the University, at which the Vice-Chancellor, Professor Stuart McCutcheon, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Vice-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by a resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Stuart McCutcheon, Vice-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Associate Dean Academic Programs, Mrs. Sue Lawrenson, to present graduands in that faculty.
Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Business and Economics. Graduate Diploma in Commerce, Ji Hyun Lee. To the degree of Bachelor of Business and Information Management, Simon Batula. Nikhil Kumar. Janita Mahesh Senanayake. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Pablo Huenhan Akunia Chandia. Mohammed Razik Asfar Zada. Gloria Arlin. Harry James Alcock. Issa Al-Khuderi. Dabika Amritalingam. Blake Rodney Anderson. Vasfosveta Vincent Aofia. Yuvani Apana. John Anthony Asteriadis. Daniela Alvileda Hernandez. Stephen Pierce Beck. Aradhana Benjamin. Root Manish Kumar Bhatt. Kamal Shreen Badisi. Truman Oscar Maxwell Birtwistle. Stephanie Melissa Blucher. Jurarat Bunparasat. Mitchell Vincent Kenneth Borger. Jamie Michelle Bowman. Georgia K. Boyle. James David Boyle. Jeremy Terence Brosnan. Cameron Wayne Brown. Philippa Claire Harkness Brown. Caitlin Elizabeth Rose Butcher. Anna Katrina Pangilinan Kalugi. Yihua Kao. Zip Wai Chan. Nikita Kumari Jan. Vanita Chandra. Katrina Lindley Charleston. Jin Yu Chen. Jin Ying Chen. Hong Wang Chen. Samuel Cheng. Ethan Chai. Kit Chiu. Hyrin Cho. Rebecca Letitia Chan. Zeling Tracy Chua. Melvin Sung Ko. Luke Thomas Colliff. Dalen Howard Concesio. Nicholas Andrew Cornwall. Callum Hugh Courtney. Samuel John Crooks. William Thomas Cullen. Daniel Evan Culpin. Charlotte Rose Couric. Joshua Andrew Davies. Chloe Michaela Davey. Luca Ding. Mumu Ding. Fong Dang Do. Isabel Ria Duncan. Corey Patrick Anthony Eady. Claudia Monique Beverly Easton. Diana Eliseva. Nishma Emil. He Won Yun. Courtney Rachel Evans. Chan Jiang Fang. Georgia Tui Faram. Trikanoa Pitatotatil Faiz Fahan. Sipili Niu Kojana Minia Lefo Fo Moina. Alice Elizabeth Kenusi Winona Lee Foot. Veronica Jane Franklin. Chi Kwang Gan. Lu Jing Gan. Jade Deborah Gardner. Benjamin Yan Sko. Nan Gong. Si Yu Gong. Himani Guma. Suraj Vipul Govan. Bansri Govan. Lucinda Jane Grief. Heilongu. Paula Jorel Mehos Gorantano. Michael James Gosh. Ji Wong Hang. Min Wu Han. Shi Yao Han. Yu Chin Han. Harry Bray Han Hum. Momoko Harada. Vaitai Vahavia. Bryce Douglas Hare. Jiawen Ho. Rairoa Nairi Heather. Neil David Heron. Logan Sean Heslop. Matthew Bryce Hicks. Dominique Philadelphia Hills. Jacqueline Wing Tung Ho. Alison Florence Hobbs. Jason Ming Hung Hun. Benjamin James Horn. Ga Wing Huang. Yi Huang. Yongjun Huang. Jimin Huang. Jessica Winona Hudson. Yojin Huang. Dana Ibrahim. Asha Calderwood Ingram. Neil Akash Jadav. Yiji. Wanji. Jikun Jiang. Muji Jiang. Nicholas Stephen Johnson. Francesca Ann Jones. Gerald Edward Jones. Nathan Stephen Karpik. Sean Brett Kaur. Lorena Sirithorn Kennedy. Priscilla Kang. Vishal Khanna. Eugene Jingu Koo. Linda Koo. Grace Kim. Michelle Minjeong Kim. Minji Kim. Soo Young Kim. Hannah Louise Kitching. Nicholas Peng Tian Ko. Yi Kong. Dong Hyun Ku. Lena Mosel Kriesel. Ji Yun Ku. Ayashna Kumar. Quan Chi Singh. Nina Luck. Alexandria Sarah Lee. Jin Wu Lee. Ju Yong Lee. Jiu Wei Lin. Rachel Wei Lee. Wu Jai Lee. Yan Hua Lee. Anja Ling. Li Jin. Kevin Lee Lee. Yang Rong Lee. Yan Tong Kerry Lee. Yun Yi Lee. Wei Min Liang. Tarina Jane Sowell Blidgard. Brian Chien Yu Lin. Li Chuan Lin. Lin Xiaotong. Xiwan Lin. Ran Cha Co OC Lindborg. Shanduan Liu. Hua Lu. Jason Liu. Jiawen Liu. Jingmen Liu. Leo Dion Liu. Liu Jia Qiong. Yu Jai Liu. Yi Zhuan Liu. Eugene Ka-Sing Lu. Hao Liu. Lo Lian Xiao. Sophie Lai. Chai Ma. Ji Ma. Annalise Mary McKenzie. Sharmel Krish Maharaj. Rupesh Mangawai. Matthew Philip Mannion. Mary Isabel Masters. Olivia Ann McLean. Jack Samuel Maguire. Chandula Malaka Medagogra. Tanya Mukulov. Kieran Alexander Merriman. Namia. Chinchen Mia. Evan James Mitchell. Mohammed Zulfikar Mohammed Alias. Angelika Moisiva. Logan Thomas Moore. Sarah Abigail Mullins. Harry Quentin Munro. Ashlyn Ashika Nair. Nargis Nazif. Chi K. Ng. Rosabel Ng Mei U. Sin Jia Ng. Claire Hai Jin Nyap. Willem Nogroho. Seung Ju Oh. Chihiro Okamoto. Elliot Pierce Olson. King Yu Joshua Ong. Tessa Dennis O'Reilly. Weichi U. Sinwom Park. Sung Su Park. Esther Parks. Renee Ranchana Pama. Jignesh Jagdish Patel. Pranesh Dylan Patel. Pritesh Patel. Roshika Ben Patel. Aidan Andrew Patterson. Alvaro Andre Pesca Gomez. Andrew Philip Patterson. Jiang Tu Pham. Rebecca Louise Phillips. Roman Proskuriakov. Pranesh Prasad. Navik Rajabut. Vishant Kashi Ram. Lena Rana. Robert James Ratre. Siki Ren. Gareth Noel Renwick. Luke John Ravel. James Alexander Ringwood. Paul Neville Rook. Javier Rook. Reuben Perry Rusco. Shoki Saga. Erica Francesca Vasque Salvador. Tara Kate Sargent. Genevieve Hui Saw. Meredith Lee Skendrit. Suman Segal. Miliama Seneca. Ji Yong Su. Franjo Anthony Sareo. Riley Elizabeth Sewell. Nazreen Banu Sheikh. Deepali Sharma. Riti Sharma. Alastair James Sherd. Kate Elizabeth Sherwood. Joshua Wei Unchong. Zhou Wei Xu. Sang Hee Sim. Carissa Delicia Simon. Matthew James Simpson. Sitanjali Shivdita Singh. Vishal Vijay Singh. John Foster Skelton. Matthew Terry Skelton Price. Hazel Melanie Smith. Rachel Reed Smith. VC Henry Jamison Soakai. Akimasa Sogabi. Matthew Raymond Carrier Sokolich. Freyan Sopariwala. Max Spencer Spires. Alexander Richard Luke Allen Stancliffe. Shelton Stanley. James Henry Stebbing. Matthew Anthony Toslin Streeton. Yun Sun. Keita Joshua Suzuki. Anna Sviridova. Vincent Wei Sing Tai. Stefano Cord Talamai Vale Masters. Chi Un Tan. Demon Tan. Demon Tan. Shayna Tan. Harrison David Taylor.
Kia chinte. Jion Tian. Tamara Lorraine Renee Tielo.
Thank you, Vice-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of the ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Manasseh Latu on vocal, accompanied by Claire Caldwell on piano, will now perform Venamon Ma Bien Ami by Eduardo Lalo.
Fléchir sa jalouse gardienne, pâlissez-moi quand t'aimes peine, aime-moi. Thank you.
vas morir.
I've left the stage, but I'll say thank you anyway. Thank you, Manasseh and Claire, for that delightful performance. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Greg Whitred, to present further graduands in the faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Roma Laetitia Timpson. Hadley Nathan Tunnicliffe. Michael Glenn Turner. Natalie Elizabeth Turton. Ryan James Turton. John Luke Tynan. Hung Nam Mary Wan. Andrew Shi Ming Wong. Bi Ying Wong. Jia Meng Wong. Jing Yi Wong. Xing Chen Wong. Yao Wong. Yi Tao Wong. Yi Yun Wong. Zi Yi Tong Wong. Chao Wei. Chu Chun Wei. Ting An Wei. Wen Kai Wei. Ada Fanua Yeta Wetzel. Anna Rose Whittington. Rebecca Jane Wilcox. Charlotte Rose Wills. Jesse Tamua Wilson. Yvonne Lemua Wilson. Cameron Michael Winefield. Kevin Wong. Lisa Hao Min Wu. Ji Hung Wu. Tian Yu Xiong. Kevin Xu. Tian Yi Yan. Hao Ting Yang. Xi Yu Yao. Wan Wan Yao. Yong Beek Ting. Sao Man Yu. Yang Yu. Zheng Jiao Li. Han Yu Zhang. Yin Nan Zhang. Jiang Lin. Lu Jiao. Xiao Di Jiao. Jia Xing Jing. Jing Xiao Ju. Peng Qian Zhou. Xu Ying Zhou. Peng Da Zhu. To the degree of Bachelor of Property, Edmund Z. Yen Boon. Shui Dan Feng. Harry Bray Henman. Meng Ji He. Yuhan Pan. Liam John Phibbs. Shi Ching Shen. Matthew Sean Topham. Saskia Christina Williams. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint, Kasna Marie Anderson and a Bachelor of Arts. Kendall Charlotte Blanche Aspen and a Bachelor of Arts. Michael Adam Beswick and a Bachelor of Arts. Sagrika Shika Chand and a Bachelor of Arts. Peter Sung Jai Chang and a Bachelor of Arts. G.J. Chen and a Bachelor of Science. Yu Jun Chen and a Bachelor of Arts. Abraham Alwyn Corbin and a Bachelor of Arts. Sophie Jasmine Day and a Bachelor of Arts. Maria Liza Barriga de la Cruz and a Bachelor of Science. Denise de Sa, and a Bachelor of Science. Leah Marie Findlay, and a Bachelor of Arts. Ian Samuel Hattrick Smith, and a Bachelor of Science. Thomas James Lomas Hill, and a Bachelor of Arts. Chu Nan Hu, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division in Mechatronics Engineering. Ji Cheng Huang, and a Bachelor of Science. Julian Terence Iosia, and a Bachelor of Science. Kate Moira Johnston, and a Bachelor of Arts. Matthew Saunders Jones, and a Bachelor of Property. Cassandra Joost, and a Bachelor of Arts. Supreet Kaur, and a Bachelor of Arts. Liam Peter Kelly, and a Bachelor of Property. Katarina Elizabeth Kettle, and a Bachelor of Science. Rachel Courtney King, and a Bachelor of Arts. Abe Lamba, and a Bachelor of Arts. Frankie Jiu Lee, and a Bachelor of Property. Yuan Ju Lee, and a Bachelor of Arts. Zhou Ying Liang, and a Bachelor of Arts. Just in case you missed that, Zhou Ying Liang, and a Bachelor of Arts. Anna Lim, and a Bachelor of Science. Michael Jonathan Lovegrove, and a Bachelor of Science. Holly Kathleen Matheson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Stephanie Lucy Duncan McCallum, and a Bachelor of Property. Mutsa Anasu Murari, and a Bachelor of Laws. Benjamin Irwin Neumeyer, and a Bachelor of Arts. Chen Kuang Ong, and a Bachelor of Science. Kieran Grayman Olmrod, and a Bachelor of Arts. Ha Young Park, and a Bachelor of Arts. Callum James Phillips, and a Bachelor of Science. Anastasia Lucy Ramsey, and a Bachelor of Science. Andrew Paul Ranford, and a Bachelor of Science. Silpa Roop, and a Bachelor of Property. Sarah Courtney Stensness Rutledge, and a Bachelor of Laws. Rianshika Sharma, and a Bachelor of Arts. Sara Muzgan Shirazi, and a Bachelor of Arts. Lisa Sum, and a Bachelor of Arts. Kevin Tanzeel, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jennifer Leah Tate, and a Bachelor of Arts. Lisa Marie Tate, and a Bachelor of Science. Stephanie Kate Tiplady, and a Bachelor of Arts. Stephanie Mei Wen To, and a Bachelor of Arts. Natasha Marie Vink, and a Bachelor of Science. Ryan David Waddingham, and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Stephanie Delise White, and a Bachelor of Arts. Scott Andrew Guok Jun Wong, and a Bachelor of Arts. Scott James Ryan Wong, and a Bachelor of Science. Eliana Lin Yi Shu, and a Bachelor of Arts. Chiao Chu Jung, and a Bachelor of Arts. Xin Di Jung, and a Bachelor of Science. Christina Danling Ju, and a Bachelor of Arts. Yelena Zidov, and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Conjoint, Ashley Rosina Baird, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Monica Bhagarath, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Thomas Henry Bishop, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Michael Elliott Harmon, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Janice Wing Nam Leung, and a Bachelor of Commerce. James Panu John Rarier, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Daniel Richard Taylor, and a Bachelor of Commerce. James Samuel McLean Wallace, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ming Chen Yu, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Postgraduate Diploma in Business. Sarah Elizabeth Bulkley in Administration. Rebecca Ann Collier York in Administration. Richard John Donaldson in Administration. Jacqueline Louise Downey in Administration. Steele Gibson in Administration. Brett Philip Hampson in Administration. Cameron Burdett Harvey in Administration. Sean Michael Hickey in Administration. Alexander Noel Ingram in Administration. David Jofin in Administration. Maura Bernadette Lenny Hahn in Administration. Ronald Lumentana in Administration. Catherine Ann Marinas in Administration. Amy Chloe Munro in Health Management. Rushdie Noor in Administration. Gregory Ian Parker in Administration. Maxim Milshatovic Siddukov in Administration. Agnes Huiyan Wong, Health Management. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours, Jordan Michael Aitkins in Information Systems. Emma Catherine Beecham in International Business. Murong Tsui in Accounting. Zach Wood, Kyle Ryan London in accounting. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division. Susan Shuming Chan in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. James Robert George Helford in Management and a Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint with Bachelor of Arts. Jiaming Hao in Finance. Solon Lim in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Solon Lim in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Elaine Victoria Soakai in International Business and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division. Kriyasha Dadi in Information Systems. To the degree of Master of Commerce with First Class Honours, Yi He in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Yi Chen Li in Information Systems. Jen Li in Information Systems. Savendra Michael in Economics. Liu Yang in Operations and Supply Chain Management. To the degree of Master of Commerce with Second Class Honours, First Division, Nicholas Joe Fong in Management. Zachary David Howell in Information Systems. Bing Kun Ju in Operations and Supply Chain Management. To the degree of Master of Commerce with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Chao Luo in Management. Sarah May Malcolm in Management. To the degree of Master of Commercialisation and Entrepreneurship, Aaron Maurice Croft. To the degree of Master of International Business, Anne Ran. Yeah. Mikhail Mikhailovic Holov. Yeah. Nguyen Thi Ngoc Duyen. Yeah. Rufinda Esna Putri. Yuyan Zhong. To the degree of Master of Management, Yi Ping Chen. Akshay Abhay Deshpand. Yun Song Fang. Akshay Gay. Jiahuan Ho. Zimu Hu. Yuan Zhou Huang. Lina Jafar. Kin Ho Leong. Ji Hong Lee. Jing Li. Lee. Wenzi Lee. Lu Hung Lin. Ching Liu. Ying Liu. Yu Jun Liu. Wei Peng. Anjira Pranakorn. Zi Xuan Chu. Qianan Tang. Xi Ying Wong. Yang Wong. Qian Wu. Ting Xu. Jin Yan. Xiao Lu Yao. Bhavan Rajaraman. Jingyi Zhang. Shi Hui Zhang. Ji Jing. To the degree of Master of Professional Accounting, Kevin Jonathan Chiputra. Alexandra Georgieva. Kalolo Justin Halfano. Jo Yi Kok. Jeffrey Chia Lin. Liu Chuan Koi. Xiao Lu Ma. So Narita. Lisa Wungun Ing. Pan Jia Li. Fam Mai Wen. Jeremiah Samuel Slade. Vinnie Stephanie. Yu Chen Su. Xiao Chen Sun. Dareth Ria Ang Si Touch. Chang Wang. Wang Xin Ting. Yu Huan Xu. Yan Shi. Shui Ru Zhao.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Faisal Abdulmohsen A. Al-Kahanti in Finance. Faisal investigated whether Islamic banks outperformed conventional banks during economic shocks. He found that while Islamic banks performed better in the early stages of the global financial crisis, they performed worse in later stages with the real economic downturn. Thus, while Islamic banks may have avoided the consequences of more volatile financial instruments, they were not immune in the face of a major economic shock. Faisal. Leila Etati in Information Systems. Leila designed and implemented adaptive tourist recommendation models, conceptual frameworks, system frameworks, architecture and application to address the key needs of travellers. The proposed artefacts are integrated, collaborative, holistic and adaptive to travel information, contexts, processes and perspectives. University doctoral scholar Marco Oegster in Finance. Marco conducted three studies examining investment decision-making processes. The first study investigated factors influencing the decision by New Zealand households to participate in the stock market. The second study examined how social interaction is related to risk-taking by retail investors. And the third analysed the trading decisions of short sellers before important announcements in the drug development process. Okay. Eli Sane, Manu Evadne, Catrion, Quintella, Sanchia, Fafida in marketing. Eli Sane examined the role of self-construal and the resistance to tobacco smoking of Tongan and New Zealand European female non-smokers and how their resistance was maintained over time. Her findings contribute to public policy makers, marketing practitioners and academics' understandings of ways to prevent smoking initiation and contributes to the New Zealand government's efforts to reduce smoking prevalence to less than 5% by 2025. Elisani. Ji Yuan Lau in accounting. Ji investigated whether firms in Japan with higher audit quality and lower accounting flexibility are more likely to report fewer negative earnings surprises arising from their forecasts. He found that firms with higher audit quality and lower accounting flexibility are indeed more likely to report fewer negative earnings surprises by adjusting their earnings expectations downwards. University doctoral scholar Jamie Ashton Newth in management. Jamie's research empirically and theoretically explored how innovation happens in social entrepreneurship, including the constraining and enabling influences of context. It was based on a long-term ethnographic investigation of an international non-governmental organisation. The research is relevant to entrepreneurs, policymakers, academics, and other stakeholders who have an interest in innovative approaches to addressing today's social and environmental problems. Jamie. Sisikula Palutea Sisifa in management. Sisikula examined the project management practices used in development projects implemented in Tonga. She looked at projects governed by donor agencies such as NZAID and the Asian Development Bank, and found that management practices must be informed by the cultural values and traditions of the social context to produce effective development outcomes for Pacific Island economies. University doctoral scholar Yu Kee Eric Tong in economics. Eric's thesis shows how US monetary policy is the critical force influencing both the default risk of banks in other countries and so-called distress fire sales by asset managers. The ensuing deterioration of financial collateral held on the balance sheets of banks and financial market participants has had a profound impact on the high unemployment experienced by many advanced economies since the global financial crisis. Alan Richard Toy in accounting. Alan investigated privacy auditing through interviews with auditors, analysis of audit reports, and analysis of information privacy laws and policy documents. His thesis has contributed to policy regarding privacy auditing criteria and the regulation of auditing, as changes to technology pose greater challenges to the information privacy rights of citizens. Sokkar Toy in marketing. Sokkar examined the nature of awkward service experiences, in particular identifying how these encounters emerged, the psychological processes consumers went through, and the subsequent negative impacts on service firms. Using samples from both New Zealand and the United States, her research not only offers novel insights about this phenomenon, but further clarifies its relationship to embarrassment. University doctoral scholar Chuan Zhou in operations and supply chain management. Chuan looked at the expiration problem in the National Medical Reserve held for an emergency response and focused on two alternatives: to rotate the reserve products to operational use and to donate to underdeveloped areas using dynamic programming, simulation, and game theoretical approaches. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for innovation in teaching has been made to Dr. Peter Smith in the Department of Management and International Business within the Faculty of Business and Economics. I call upon a student of that faculty, Jessica Crewe Brown, to read the citation for Dr. Smith.
Today, I am thrilled to present to you Peter Smith to acknowledge his commitment to teaching excellence. In a variety of courses which Peter facilitates, he commits himself to delivering quality by bridging the gap between academic theory and practitioner reality. The courses which he teaches stand out as being some of the most stimulating and useful subjects as they facilitate real-world experiences. In these simulated real-world environments, Peter creates opportunities for students to think and inquire as they make their way through uncertainty and complexity. Courses with the greatest learnings come from those with the greatest challenges, but we only often realize this with retrospection, perhaps the most useful skill Peter nurtures. The majority of his courses are self-directed learnings, as in what you put in is what you get out. He teaches in a way that makes you participate, not because you have to, but because you want to, by bringing fun and competition to the classroom. In a number of classes, colleagues of Peter have commented on his excellence in what he does for both the university and the community. This speaks volumes to who Peter is as a person. Bringing out the best in his students through unique teaching capabilities, Peter propels his students to excellence. When a teacher believes in the ability of his students, the ability becomes a reality. We start achieving because we realize our true potential. Peter is always smiling and his positivity is contagious. His door's always open and you can always count on him for conversation and guidance, provided he is not out having a run. So I speak for both past and present students when I say, Peter, keep doing what you're doing and teaching what you teach, because I believe you exemplify teaching excellence.
We are now nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. While you are standing, this would be a great opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of Council in convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme.